Welcome to this short presentation on the issues to consider for patients with hereditary thoracic aneurysm disease who are considering pregnancy. There are five main aspects to consider. The first is the risk of recurrence, that is, the risk of the baby inheriting thoracic aneurysm disease. This is discussed in more detail in a separate pill of knowledge video on genetic counselling. The next consideration is the risk of an aortic event for both the mother during pregnancy and during the delivery. The third aspect to consider is the risks for the fetus. The fourth aspect is the risks associated with medications that may be used during pregnancy. The final consideration is the risk of further progressive disease in the mother. When you are considering pregnancy, we strongly advise that you see and discuss this with your cardiologist who knows your case. We provide an overview of the considerations, but appropriate advice for you will need to be individualised according to your circumstances and personal history. As part of the pre-pregnancy assessment to determine the risks for you, we advise that you should have imaging of the entire aorta in order to identify whether there are any abnormal areas that are dilated or aneurysmal that may be at greater risk of either dissection or rupture during pregnancy or delivery. This is usually performed using echocardiography to assess the aortic root and either MRI or CT to evaluate the rest of the aorta that cannot be easily seen using echocardiography. The assessment will also identify whether there are any other risk factors for an aortic event, such as high blood pressure, whether there has been any progressive dilatation of parts of the aorta, and whether there is a family history of aortic dissection or rupture. If you are found to have high blood pressure, then it is important that this is addressed in order to reduce the risk of complications. As well as assessment of the aorta, it is also important to identify whether there are any other issues that would be of relevance for pregnancy, such as spinal abnormalities that can occur in some patients with Marfan syndrome, which may affect how anaesthesia can be given during delivery. Epidural anaesthesia may not be possible in some cases if there are spinal abnormalities. Pregnancy, delivery, and the early postpartum period are known to be times of increased risk of aortic dissection and rupture. This is due to both the hormonal changes that occur with pregnancy, which lead to softening of the tissues, as well as hemodynamic changes in the cardiovascular system as a result of the increased circulating blood volume and the strains during delivery. If your aorta is particularly dilated or has grown significantly prior to pregnancy, sometimes we advise prophylactic surgical intervention before considering pregnancy in order to reduce the risk of aortic dissection or rupture. This is a very individualized decision, taking into account several factors, including size of your aorta, whether there has been any growth in the size of your aorta, your family history, the results of any genetic testing, and the short and long-term risks of the potential surgical procedures. The balance of risks for you should be discussed with your cardiologist, who may also discuss with the wider multidisciplinary team. Some medications that are often used in patients with heritable thoracic aneurysm disease are associated with an increased risk of development of fetal abnormalities. The most common of these are the ACE inhibitor drugs and angiotensin receptor blocker drugs, such as ramipril, lisinopril, candesartan, losartan, and irbesartan. This risk has to be balanced against the risk for the mother if the medications are stopped. We therefore advise that you discuss your medications with your cardiologist. If it is considered safe for you to stop your medications, then ideally this should be done 3 months prior to considering pregnancy. Sometimes a switch to an alternative is advised. If you are taking beta blocker drugs, then these should be continued, and some patients will be advised to switch to a beta blocker from ACE inhibitor or angiotensin receptor blockers. A Atenolol is associated with risks for the fetus, so patients who are taking atenolol should switch to an alternative that is safer in pregnancy. This is usually either bisoprolol, metoprolol, or propranolol. It is important that your blood pressure is well controlled during pregnancy and should be maintained at less than 130 over 80 millimetres of mercury. It is important that your blood pressure is regularly monitored, and if it is consistently above this level, then your cardiologist will advise on what additional medication may be appropriate both before and during pregnancy. If you are taking beta blocker drugs, then this can be associated with restriction in growth of the fetus, and therefore you should have regular scans to monitor the growth of the baby. As discussed in more detail in the genetic counselling pill of knowledge, where one parent has a genetically confirmed condition that is associated with the development of thoracic aneurysm disease, there may be up to a 1 in 2 chance that the baby will inherit the same genetic mutation. Pre-implant genetic diagnosis and selection and re-implantation of unaffected embryos may be possible. Please discuss this with your team, who may refer you for further specialist discussion. This can be a lengthy process, so it is worth discussing this early with your cardiologist. Because of the risk of aortic dissection and rupture, current guidelines advocate that pregnancy should not continue for longer than 40 weeks. Your obstetric and cardiology team will discuss with you about the balance of risks of induced delivery and the waiting for a natural labour to start depending on your individual circumstances. There is a slightly increased risk that your baby may be small. During pregnancy, it is important that you are monitored regularly by a specialist joint cardiac and obstetric team. The frequency will be determined by your team and may change during the course of the pregnancy if there are signs of growth of your aorta during pregnancy. The assessment of your aorta will mostly be with echocardiography, but sometimes an MRI scan during pregnancy may be advised. MRI scans can be performed safely during pregnancy and is often performed without contrast injections. If you develop severe chest pain and your doctors are concerned that you may have developed an aortic dissection, then a CT scan may be recommended. In this situation, it is vital that the correct diagnosis is made, as if there has been an aortic dissection or rupture, then making this correct diagnosis may be life-saving for the mother. In this situation, the benefits of the CT scan in confirming the diagnosis are considered to outweigh the risks of radiation exposure for the fetus. Your doctors will advise you of the risks and benefits of any scans that are considered during pregnancy. Many women, including those with a mildly dilated aortic root, are still able to have a normal vaginal delivery. Some women are also able to deliver in their local centre, but some women are advised to have their antenatal care and delivery at a specialist centre. If the aorta is very dilated or has grown during pregnancy, then caesarean section delivery may be considered. Your team will discuss individual delivery plans with you at your antenatal visits, including timing and mode of delivery. This will take into account several factors, including the size of your aorta, any growth of your aorta, obstetric factors such as previous obstetric complications, breech presentation, and placental issues, and geographical issues such as how far away from the hospital you live. The period of increased risk of aortic dissection and rupture continues into the early postpartum period until the hemodynamic and hormonal changes have resolved. This can take a few weeks. A follow-up assessment of the aorta is advised in the first few months after pregnancy to look for any late changes in the size of your aorta. Some medications are excreted in breast milk, and therefore the fetus may be exposed to this if they are breastfed. We advise that you discuss with your doctors about what the balance of risks is between the potential benefits of the medication for the mother and the risks of any medication for the fetus. Sometimes neonatal monitoring may be advised. Thank you for listening.